of C++ and basic concept of C++. Firstly, we will discuss C. C is developed by Dennis Ritchie. After C, C++ is generated. C++ is an extension of C. There exists C++, that is an incremental operator. There are few new concepts are added under the C. After added new concept, the new name is provided to the C, that is called C++. That's why there exists plus symbol, that is an extension of C. That is an extension of C, that's why we call that is C++. C++ is generated by Jeremy Troustow in 1980. That is based on object-oriented programming. Object-oriented programming is a methodology with classes and objects that contain classes and also objects. Classes represent behavior of object. Object contains attribute and functions. Classes is a collection of similar type of objects. Object implement template or class in the real world. Object contains attribute and also function, or object is also instance of the class. We are taking one example, that is mobile. Mobile is an object. Mobile object contains different attribute and also functions. Different attribute of mobiles are model, price, color, etc. And there are different functions of mobile are call, video, audio, and also etc. There are other examples of objects are class. There are other examples of objects. Car is an object. There are different attributes of car: color, model, price, etc. And there are different functions of car are start, stop, move, other, etc. Classes are collection of similar type of object, or we can say object is an instance of the class. Object implement template class under the real world. Object-oriented concept contains classes and also objects. C++ is partially object-oriented language, that is not fully object-oriented language, that is not completely dependent on classes and also objects. Some concepts use classes and objects under the C++, and some use simple concept under the C++. There are other features, other basic concepts of C++ are dynamic binding. Under the dynamic binding, the code is not known until the runtime. The example of dynamic binding is, firstly we are taking one procedure, that is called draw. Under the draw function, we will generate the different shapes like circle, oval, ellipse, etc. It is the example of dynamic binding. Next, basic concept of OOPs is polymorphism. Polymorphism word comes from Greek. It is a Greek word. Polymorphism means ability to take more than one form. Under this concept, we add two numbers, that will generate the third number. And similarly, we will add two strings, that will generate third string by the concatenation operation. Polymorphism is also divided into the two parts, compile time and also runtime. Compile time will contain function overloading and also operator overloading, and runtime polymorphism contains virtual function. Again, one example of polymorphism is draw function. We are taking one function, or with the help of one function we will generate the different shapes onto the screen. Like we are taking one function draw, under the draw function we can generate the different objects, different shapes onto the screen like circle, oval, ellipse, etc. It is an example of polymorphism, that means we will generate the different forms onto the screen. That means polymorphism generates ability to take more than one form. Operation is one, function is one, but that will generate the different output onto the screen. The next basic concept is inheritance. Under the inheritance, Derived class inherits all the features of base class. That process is called inheritance. Under the inheritance, we can say one super class or one subclass, one parent class or one child class, one base class or one derived class. Derived class inherits all the features of base class. That process is called inheritance. Or also we can say under the inheritance, object acquire the property of another object. That process is called inheritance. There are different types of inheritance. First is single inheritance. Under the single inheritance, derived class inherits all the features of base class. That is called single inheritance. Next is multi-level inheritance. Under the multi-level inheritance, derived class inherits all the features of base class. Again, derived class will act as a intermediary base class. Again, next derived class will find out from the intermediary base class. That process is called multi-level inheritance. Under the multi-level inheritance, we are taking one example like grandfather, father and also son. Son is father inherit all the features of grandfather. Again, father will act as a base class. Orphan will inherit all the features of father and also grandfather. That is an example of multi-level inheritance. Next is multiple inheritance. Under the multiple inheritance, it is a process in which more than one base class and one derived class. That process is called multiple inheritance. Next process is hierarchical inheritance. Under the hierarchical inheritance, one base class and multiple derived class. That process is called hierarchical inheritance. Next is hybrid inheritance. Hybrid inheritance is a combination of two inheritance. We are taking one multi-level inheritance and also multiple inheritance. That process is called hybrid inheritance. After that, next concept is abstraction. Abstraction, the act of representing the essential task and hiding the previous data. That process is called abstraction. Next concept is encapsulation, wrapping the data and function into the single unit. That process is called encapsulation. In encapsulation, only those functions which wrapped inside the class will access the data. Other functions can't access that data. That means that data will not accessible from outside the world. That process is called encapsulation. Encapsulation also use the concept of polymorphism and also inheritance. Next concept, basic concept is message passing. Message passing, under the message passing, then we will create the class. After that, create the object. Large number of objects we will create under the classes. There are different type of objects under the class. We can create number of objects inside the class. After creating class, we can generate the object and object implement the class. Under the implementation process, object can communicate with another object for the communication or for passing the message from one object to the another object. Under the message passing, one object can communicate with other object and also transferring the messages or sending the messages from one object to the another object. That process is called message passing. All these are the basic concept of C++. For again, we will revise. Firstly, we are using class. Class is a similar type of object. Under that class, for secondly, we are using object. Object implement classes. And next we are using is dynamic binding. Under the dynamic binding, the process is not known until the time of call at runtime. We are taking the example of dynamic linking, that is a draw function. Under the draw function, we generate the different type of object onto the screen like circle, oval, ellipse, etc. Under the next is inheritance. Under the inheritance, derived class inherits all the features of base class. That process is called inheritance. Next is abstraction, act of representing essential tasks and without including previous data. That process is called abstraction. There are list of attributes of abstractions are size, weight, cost, etc. Function to operate on these attribute. Next is encapsulation, wrapping the data into the single unit. That process is called encapsulation. And next, the last one is message passing. Under the message passing, one object can communicate with other object, or one object can transfer the messages from one object to the another object. This process is called message passing. Thank you.